The opinion of which I am rapporteur is about social security coordination across the European Union. This is an update on current legislation, current regulations, and in fact the need for this update has long been felt, because obviously we have more people now working across the European Union. In fact, the total number of persons working across the European Union numbers 8.5 million. So there is obviously clear need for an update. However, in terms of the update per se, there are three issues which are of concern to the European Economic and Social Committee. One is the requirement for which persons working in another member state would be entitled to social security benefits. The requirement now is that you have to have at least 3 months work in another member state, and you have to obviously prove this. Currently, there are no requirements, and therefore this imposes a new restriction on the mobility of workers. The second concern is about the extension of exporting the entitlement to unemployment benefits from the current 3 to 6 months. Now, this appears positive prima facie. However, it really doesn't make any difference to persons looking for work and ultimately could become unemployed after a period of time, because again, extending from 3 to 6 months really doesn't make any difference at all. The third concern, which I believe is actually the greatest concern of all, is regarding the entitlement to social security benefits for economically inactive persons, those persons that are not seeking work, but for instance could be accompanying their partner or spouse in another member state where that spouse or partner wishes to work. The decision or the proposal by the European Commission is actually to codify a European court decision whereby those who are economically inactive persons would only be entitled to social security benefits as long as they prove they have subsistence, they can actually live in terms of their financial means, and also the requirement to have financial means for health coverage. Now, these, in my view, are restrictive, and actually could in a way go or run counter to the Charter on Fundamental Human Rights across the European Union. So clearly, in this case, the European Economic and Social Committee should voice its concern, because actually this proposal could actually restrict movement of persons across the European Union.